There's a fascinating analysis in the New York Times about who voted for whom and why in the 2020 presidential contest, if we can throw that up on the screen. So headline here, counties that suffered higher unemployment rates voted for Biden. The opening graph says the counties won by President-elect Joe Biden experienced worse job losses on average during the initial wave of pandemic layoffs than the counties where President Trump was strongest in his bid for re-election. So places that were hit hardest economically during the coronavirus pandemic were more likely to vote for Joe Biden. Now, there's a couple things that it seems like is going on here. First is kind of the obvious one. If things went really poorly for you under the current president, then you're like, let me do something different. But the other dynamic here is that blue counties and suburbs and urban environments tended to be hit harder in general because they tend to be more centered around the service economy. So that also is underlying this dynamic. But it's pretty fascinating to see it.
No, it really is. So, yeah, the blue and the red thing is something I've been trying to get my head around. My most likely explanation is that red counties are probably more rural and so therefore are not suffering from the large ex-urban, suburban, like city fallout. That's possibly what it is. And look, we're not going to know everything, but this generally holds on the state-by-state basis, too. So that's another thing that we might be able to think about. It's very conceivable that in larger counties and where the economic problems have been bigger, largely because they have more of the economy, like Maricopa, that might be one of the reasons why they flipped around, including some of that college-educated white population. So it's crazy because if you pair this up, at the same time, Biden did win the richest counties in America, like the 70% of the 455 counties, which constitute 70% of the American economy, all went for Biden, largely, you know, urban, urban, ex-urban, suburban are the ones there. And then downtrodden counties went for Trump in terms of the aggregate. So there's a lot to be
there's a lot to unpack.
I don't know what to tell you.
It makes sense. You know, people, we noted that stat before Election Day of a majority of Americans said they were actually better off financially than they were when Trump came into office. And it was one of those numbers that were kind of like, not sure what to make of that, because it's very different from, you know, a lot of the macro trends. Certainly didn't match with the polling that we were seeing that had Biden up 10 and 12 points nationally, et cetera. And so when it came down to it, voters who said that the economy was their number one issue, they voted overwhelmingly for Donald Trump. And voters, I saw some of the data that said that they were doing better economically now than they were in the past, also overwhelmingly favored Donald Trump. So it kind of makes sense in that context of like places that weren't hit as hard economically and bounced back quicker felt like, okay, this guy's got this under control. This is going to be fine for me and my family. We can move forward under this current regime. And people, places that were hit harder and saw more of the job losses around them were more likely to back Joe Biden. But like I said, I also think some of this is just correlation because I think blue places tended to be, you know, they tend to be cities. They tend to be more like Clark County, Nevada, you think about where Las Vegas is. And that's an area that's pretty strongly Democratic. And it's the hardest hit in the entire country in terms of unemployment and job loss, because obviously it's all based around the service sector economy. So I think that's part of what's playing out here as well.
But I think that's right. It's very interesting to see who and what. And I think what I really want to see is the next midterms after coronavirus, because then all the like chaos in the system will be gone and you'll actually see what the real realignment will be.
Will it?
Although,
who the hell
knows?
I really don't know. Yeah. I mean, there is a scenario, like, I think both of us expectations for the Biden are fairly dim.
Boring, yeah.
But a lot of how president's perceived has to do with just when they take office.
That's
and,
true.
And, you know, the bar has been set so low in terms of how terrible things have been in America with the pandemic and the economic collapse and the lack of an economic response and unrest in the streets, that if things just sort of naturally on their own get better and he's able to effectively deliver a vaccine or something you've been pointing to for a long time.
That's all he has to do.
There's a lot of sense of like, oh, there's going to be this backlash in the midterms. That's not written in stone. That is what normally happens throughout history. But there is a scenario where through basically no doing of his own, Joe Biden is actually sitting pretty well just based on the underlying trends moving in the economy. So, I'm not saying that is what's going to happen, but it's certainly one possibility that's out there at this point. All right, we'll have more Rising for you after this.